Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri, presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can control a servo motor using a push button and Arduino. When you push this push button and keep pressed, it goes between 0 and 180 degrees. When you release it at any moment, it will just stop. And you can set it between any angle, for example, between 10 and 150. Now, if I keep it pressed, it goes between 10 and 150. So you can set your boundary. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. I will reply to all comments and questions of my channel subscriber. Make sure to subscribe and leave the notification on. I have different types of code for controlling servo motor using push buttons because they are required in many applications. Also, I have a project that you can control a servo motor using push button. When you press the push button, the servo motor moves either from 0 to 180 and stops, or moves from 180 to 0 and stops. Also, I have a project that you can control a servo motor using push button. When you press the push button, the servo motor starts from 0 to 180 and returns back as long as you keep the push button pressed. When you release the push button, the servo motor will stop. Also, I have another project that you can control a servo motor using two push buttons. One push button to move the servo motor to the right, and the other push button will move the servo motor to the left. When you release the push button, the servo motor will stop. Also, I have a project that you can control 16 servo motors with different type of codes. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let me briefly explain the servo motor. Servo motor is a type of motor that the shaft can be controlled to move only 180 degrees or half a circle, something like that. And then you can control precisely where it should be between 0 and 180 degrees. There are also other types of servo motors that, for example, there is something called continuous servo, which I have the link below. It will rotate 360 degrees. And these are the most common one. And also you might get this type of servo motor, which is very heavy with high torque. It is the same way. It can go 0 to 180 degrees. And it will stop. So this is MG966R version, and this is the metal gear. This is all metal, and this is a plastic gear. So this will be much cheaper, like 3 or 4 or 5 times cheaper than this. But in general, this is the operation. And so the servo motor has 3 wires. The darker wire is the ground. The 5 volts is always at the middle in case you make mistake in terms of connection in RC or car or airplane. So the middle is always 5 volts. And this is a signal. You might see it as a black wire on this side. Red is always red. And this side you might see white, but doesn't matter. So they are the same. Configuration is exactly the same. Ground, 5 volts, and signal. Now let me explain the wiring. For the wiring, I'm using this push button here. The push button is of long pin type, two pins. It makes it easy. You can get it from eBay or Amazon. I have the link below this video. So the 2 pin of this push button is connected to the ground and to pin 2. So my push button is connected to these 2 pins. My servo, which has 3 wires, I've connected using this extra extension here to make it easy. Connect the brown wire to the ground of Arduino, the middle pin to 5 volts, and the signal wire, orange, to pin 2 in this case. And if you pay attention here, we have tilde at pin 3. Pin 3, sorry, and then tilde is here, 5, 6, and 9, 10, 11. These are all pulse modulation enabled pin. For example, 7 and 8 will not work, 4 will not work, so keep that in mind. Let me now explain the code. We are including the servo header. The servo.h is part of the Arduino IDE. You don't need to download anything, it's already available. But in this line, we are using this servo class, and we create an instance of it. We call it my servo. And in this line, define servo pin. We define pin 3 for servo to be connected, the signal line. And this is a pin that has tilde. You can choose any other pin that has tilde, which means it's pulse width modulation enabled. And we use push button pin 2 for push button pin, which we will use across the code. And this angle initial value, you can set other value if you wish. Step is the increment step. Every time it moves from one value to other in the increment of 5. If you want it to go faster, make it 10, 15, whatever you want. If you want to make it very slow or precise, go to even 1 degree. And these two values are minimum and maximum of angle. I put this because sometimes you don't want from 0 to 180, let's say you want from 0 to 90, or you want from 100 to 120, or some value. But if you want 0 to 180, leave it as is. Keep that in mind, because this is minimum angle. This value must be smaller than this value, otherwise this code will not work. Inside the setup, from here to here, this happens only once. Serial.begin initializes the serial monitor. Serial monitor can be accessed by clicking at Tools, Serial Monitor, or pressing Control Shift and M, or on the right side here, you can click, and this is the serial monitor, will open and will print this text. At the right side, at the lower corner, you will see this number. From here, you can set the baud rate, 9600 baud or 9600 bit per second. This, if I close it, this is the value. It must match, otherwise you will not be able to read the value. My servo.attach servo pin. This is as if I type 3 here, so pin 3 will be assigned to the servo. And pin mode push button pin, this is pin 2. This is as if I type 2. We have defined it here. We're defining this pin as an input, but I'm using also pull-up. The pull-up job is to eliminate usage of a resistor. When the button is not pressed, it always pulls it up or pulls it to 5 volts. A separate video explaining that. If you do not use this pull-up or just use input, you need to use a resistor. And then serial.print, this just prints a text. You see the double quotation, so this is our text. And then my servo.write angle, you can put a value here and the servo moves to that location. Because this is inside the setup, this is our initial position of the servo. If you want to put any other value or something, just put here, the servo will be initially at that location. And inside the loop, we use while and digital read push button, and we read the push button value, and we are checking it. If it is equal low, then the push button is pressed. We have to do something. Here we take the angle and add this. If this was 90, this will be plus 10, it will be 100. So we increment it, and then angle will be there. And here we check if angle is smaller than minimum angle, smaller than equal, or this pipe or two vertical line or called pipe character, or angle is greater than or equal maximum, which means it's above 180, it means below zero, so we should not allow it. Immediately we change the direction by adding this minus, will be stored here. So let's say if this was 90, this is minus 10, minus 90 plus minus 10 will be 80. So the calculation will be 80, and the servo, which in this line we use my servo.write angle, instead of 90, it will go into 80. So this portion, the job of this one is to just keep it within the boundary. And then we use serial.print move to. This is a text, you see the double quote, and this is the actual angle that we have will be printed here, and with a space we print the word degree. And you see print, and this has ln mean new line, so these will be shown side by side, and this will create new lines. So this will be printed as one line, and we give it 100 milliseconds for the servo to reach to that position. You can play with this if you wanted to speed it up, reduce this value, but you cannot go very low, below certain value depending on your servo, because the servo will not respond, and it will have no meaning if you go below certain value. And then the loop will continue, take the same action over and over again. Now let me demonstrate it. The code I've been loaded to my Arduino Uno, and serial monitor is open here. Initial value was 90, so it's at the middle. Now when I press this, it will start moving, and also it shows on the serial monitor. Now it is set between 0 and 180 degrees at any moment, but if I keep it pressed, it goes to the two boundaries of upper and lower, and will stop when I release it. If I set this, let's say, between 80 and 130, let me upload it. Now this will go within. If I press it, you will see that it goes, it starts from 100, 110, and it goes back to 190, and then those values, so it stays within the bound. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. If you are a subscriber of my channel, I always try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. Or control them one by one. Or just control, for example, 5.